Yo, what it is, what it ain't. It's your host, Darius Henderson. I'm here with star quarterback, Nate Dick.
What's up?
This is No Shame, 100 yards of mental games. Me and Nate are going to walk the length of the football field and have a real talk about mental health and being a student athlete. That being said, Nate, let's get straight to it. Yeah, so Nate, I mean, just being a student athlete and just, you know, being a quarterback, I just know football in particular, you guys have a very, very rigorous schedule given. 6 a.m. workouts, then you got team meetings, then you got class, then you got to eat. You know what I mean? So like, I'm just curious, like, how does like that, all that take a toll on like your mental health?
I think the biggest thing when you say that is, you know, we're 18 to 22 years old, so we got to have a, you know, have relationships with people too and have a social life, you know, to try to balance all that stuff together. It is extremely tough, you know, at times and stuff like that, and it's really something that we need to kind of like talk about more is like, you know, a lot of the coaches talk about like our physical side, you know, how's our body doing all that stuff. Right. But, you know, I think our coaches do a really good job of checking in on us mentally, you know, and seeing like if you need help, you know, to go talk to someone, whether it's a coach, another player, or just like a family friend.
That's so dope. Because I, quick story, I remember I was in Uber, and the Uber driver, I asked him, like, how you doing today? And he started crying, just like busting out tears. Going on, he was like, wow, like, do you believe no one has asked me how am I doing? So I'm just like simply asking, like, how you doing today? It's like, can go a long way. So, like, that's crazy. I'm glad your coaches are able to do that. But so what about injuries? I know you're an athlete, so how you ever experienced being hurt? Like, how does that affect your mental health, being able to bounce back from an injury?
Absolutely, yeah. So I've actually had kind of a, I shouldn't say a curse, but I've had a, you know, two injuries the last 2 years. I broke both my feet, you know, the second game of the year and stuff like that. So yeah, I mean, talking about that, I think the biggest thing is, you know, a lot of people talk about, you know, the physical side of, you know, doing the reps, you know, like doing all the rehab and stuff like that, you know, just to try to get right, you know, but a lot of people don't talk about how mentally draining that is, you know, to be able to tell yourself again, like, hey, like, I gotta trust myself, I gotta trust that my feet are gonna be okay, I gotta tell myself, like, I can still do this, pretty much, like, I still have this ability, you know, and just that constant reminder of doing that all the time. And I think, I mean, like I said before, is the biggest thing is just to talk to someone about it, you know, whether it's like your parents, you know, one or two friends, like whatever, you know, someone that's always in your corner, that's always going to tell you, like, on those days where you don't want to go do your rehab, you don't want to go do all that stuff because you're hurt and you're tired. But, you know, just to have those people to kind of just put their arm around you and be like, hey, we're going to do this together, you know, you're not in this alone, you're going to do this together. And that's really helped me, you know, come back from both my injuries personally. So,
wow, that's dope. Well, I mean, Andrew, do you think that made you more resilient? Just mentally, just knowing you can bounce back. So, like, let's say when you're done with football, you get a job, you know, it's like nothing. You know what I mean? It ain't going to last forever.
Yeah, honestly, I think, you know, playing a collegiate athlete, doesn't matter what sport it is, it's probably going to be the hardest thing I'm ever going to do in my life, you know. So I think that's one thing that our coaches really implement into us is that, you know, if you can do all this stuff, show up to weights on time, show up to practice on time, you know, and give 100% effort all the time, you know, you're gonna be all right in life. You're like, you're gonna do things the right way and things are really gonna go your way. But, you know, you talk about adversity and being resilient, I think the biggest thing is, like, on a football field, like, not everything's gonna go your way, you know, and stuff like that, or any sport really,
any sport,
you know, but just to have that, you know, that guy to lean on, or to be that person, be like, hey, no, let's go, like, we got this, like, no matter what, and, you know, we're gonna come out on top and we're gonna be great.
That's dope. Well, hey, there you have it. 100 yards, Mitchell Gang, star quarterback, Nate Dick. But hold on, Nate, I'm gonna go long. We're gonna end it like this.
Hey, back in my day, I used to kill it. Hold on.
I dropped my phone.
Hold on.
Up top, Nate.
Man, no way. You better add that. That's the best ball I've thrown all week. When you do me like that. I came to get down. So get out your seat and
jump around. Jump around. Hey, we crossed the goal line. Nate. I'm in bounds. I got two down. Up top, Nate.
Yeah.